Hi guys, last session we had very brief information about language and all. Anyhow, that can be discussed in earlier later sessions also. Now let us start discussing on the design of automatons, where that is what is main important thing with respect to this subject. Now we mainly concentrate on the finite state machine, which is called as FSM. Sometimes it is also called as finite state automata, where in short I can call it as FSA. Some will also call it as just finite automata, so it is FA. Now whatever it is, it would be either finite state machine, finite state automata, or just a finite automata. Let us first know how do I represent it. Before representing, I should know what an automata should contain. Now, forget about all these topics. Just understand or take an example of a machine. Now, I can say a vehicle is also a machine. Let me take an example of car. When you consider car, I can say car is either moving or it is at rest. Car is under motion, car is under rest. At every point of time, I need to know what is the state of the car. Overall, when you talk about any automata, automata should have something called as state, where state says the situation or a condition or a scenario for a particular automata at some particular time. Now the state may be changed during time. The question is, how can I change the state? Remember, when I want to change a state, there is something required which is called as input. Say for example, same example as car. If I want to change the state of a car from rest to motion, I may have to give input as a key, or I may have to start. Mean to say, there is some external input provided. So, automata should have state as well as input. The process of changing state from one to another is said to be a transition. Whatever it is, whether you change the state from motion to rest or rest to motion with an example of a car, the process is said to be a transition. To be defined in a proper way, a transition is the process of changing state from one to another on receiving an input. Now, when I say there is a transition is happening from one state to another. But remember, it may not be always happening to a new state. I'm underlining the word, the new state. Again, take a same example. If I say car, the state has been changed from rest to motion. It is moving. Even if you increase the speed by changing the gear, even then the car will be in same state. Even though I am giving input it successively, there is a change of a state, but there is a change of a state from the same state to itself. So transition may happen from one state to another state, where another state may not be a new state. Next, at any point of time, automata or a machine should start. So that is called as initial state or start state. Similarly, automata should stop at some point of time. So we say final state or acceptance state. Whenever I talk about automata, these are five things required to represent it. So now, as soon as I say automata, I should have state, input, transition, initial or start state, final or accepting state. One more thing I want to specify, where when I talk about input, I said transition would happen on some input. That's what I said. But there could be some modification also. There could be a transition from one state to another without any input symbol. This could be given in any example. Say suppose you have an inclined plane. You have a inclined surface. You have kept the ball somewhere here. Without you giving any input, or without you applying a force, or you without you pushing it, I can say the ball will move on the surface and comes here. Remember, without giving any input, there is a change of a state from one to another, and it could happen. So now that could be represented as epsilon, which we call it as empty string, as discussed in the previous session. Anyhow, there are much more to go with respect to these items. We'll discuss about this in next few sessions. In this session, we discussed about the finite state machine or a finite state automata. It is in turn called as finite automata, which has 5 ingredients or 5 tuples: state, input, transition, initial or start state, final or accepting state. To end up, please understand, FSM or FSA would be coming under some type of language called as a regular language. It was supposed to specify it earlier itself. Where regular language is a language which it seems to be easy compared to others and easy to write a DFA, FAs. Anyhow, I should discuss about division of languages in later sessions. Thank you.